Hello, family. I'm back again with another wonderful fruit dish. This is soup here. I have watermelon gazpacho. And this is your vegan goddess, more holistic. I thought I'd share this with you. It's my first time making it, and it looks pretty good. I haven't even tasted it yet, but what I'll tell you what the recipe has in it. It has 3 cups of chopped watermelon, plus you want 1 slice for garnishing, 1 large heirloom tomato, 2 celery stalks, 1/4 red onion, 4 garlic cloves, 2 scallion greens, roughly chopped, a zest, like 1/4 of lime and remaining lime peels for garnish on top of it, which I kind of skipped that part because my lime was kind of, it didn't have what I needed. But anyways, 1/4 cup of avocado oil, and more. That's optional, it's for a garnish, the drizzle on it. So you have drizzled that oil on there. And 1 teaspoon of red wine vinegar, pinch of salt, a pinch of black pepper. Throw that all into a food processor until you get the consistency you like. And then you can garnish the oil on top of it and squeeze a little lime juice on it. And I should have garnished a lime peel, but I didn't. And I'm gonna taste it right now. It's good. It's really good, y'all. I'm gonna take off that bubbly part. It's so delicious. This is watermelon gazpacho. G-A-Z-P-A-C-H-O. Watermelon gazpacho. You know, that's comes from Spain. A tomato kind. All tomato. But anyways, what I'm gonna do is cover it, put it in the refrigerator overnight, and all the flavors will marry, will taste better. But it does taste delicious now, because I can't imagine what it's gonna taste like tomorrow. I'll have it for maybe lunchtime or maybe breakfast, depending on how I feel. So that's all I have to say, a little short little clip. Let you get a close-up of it. It got some bubbles in there, trying to get those bubbles out. Bubbles. Okay. It tastes so good. So, see, a fruitarian, you can do all kind of wonderful things with fruit. That's combining those watermelon and heirloom tomatoes together. Whoever thought, who would have knew they would go together? But they're both fruits, so, you know, the fruit world's pretty big, because a lot of vegetables get classified as vegetables when they're fruits. Like your, cucumbers, tomatoes, okra, zucchini, squash, anything that has a seed in it, technically is a fruit. So that's all I wanted to share with you today. I hope you're doing fine, eating all that fruit. And I'll come across another recipe, I'll share it with you. Because this is gonna be the recipe of survival. So we can survive as a people, and the planet can survive. Because with all that eating of all the beef and stuff, like we talked about before, cutting down all the rainforest to expand more land. And as the earth gets more people and expand, they're going to be, and they get that more addiction for meat. I know they make a lot of profit off of it. So they're going to push it over into the developing countries and cut down more rainforests and lose all these beautiful animals and birds and lizards and whatnot, just so people can have hamburgers and steaks. And so, yeah, we'll get into that later, but yeah, try this out. Like, you know, you can make a small difference. Each individual person can play their part in stopping the destruction of the earth through the consumption of animal products. Stay away from all animal products. All animals, your cows, your pigs, your ducks, your fish. Fish. Fish is even more contaminated than your land animals because of, you know, all the, feces, water, and stuff from these factory farms. They end up in the rivers and streams, and they're going out into the oceans, forming dead zones, and then all that pollution gets to the fish, so they're like stewing in it. You know, see what I'm saying? They're stewing in it. So you're like, you eat marinated cow poop and whatnot. Okay, I don't want to leave you on a down note, but yeah, see how delicious that is? Oh, it's so delicious. Ah, so tasty. Oh, it just brings me so much joy looking at it. Oh my God, don't you see it? See how much better your body will smell inside and out when you're eating something like this? Well, anyways, give it a try. Let me know what you think. And have a wonderful day and a beautiful life. Only if you eat the fruit of life. Make it better for yourself, better for the animals, so you don't have to eat them. They want to live a long, happy life and do what they do, so we can save the oceans and everything, and all the water, and also, you know, that when they have that those factory farms with all that cow manure and cow waste, it evaporates into the you know, from the waters into the sky and turns into acid rain. So it's just like a domino effect. It's so deep, y'all. It's so deep. Oh my. But yes, again, like I said, you can do your part and be a fruitarian or a raw vegan or just a vegan. Give it a shot. Okay? Remember, you're a vegan goddess. Let's all be more holistic. Be a fruitarian today. Thank you so much. Share this. Give me a thumbs up. Share it. You can stay young and youthful too. You won't wrinkle up and get all fat and out of shape. Like I see so many American people just so big and fat with big stomachs and oversized and looks horrible. I know people are not into fat shaming. I'm not fat shaming or nothing like that. I'm just saying that's, you should, everybody should be at their normal weight. But because they put all those, what you call it, enzymes and all these antibiotics into the cow's flesh so they don't catch all the disease because the places are so nasty and has so many, you know, and they want them to gain weight really fast, them and the chickens and the eggs and everything. That's why you see all this massive overweight on everybody. And then plus the businesses like the, what do you call them, the fast food places, they want you to supersize everything big and all the advertisements. So everybody now is so big, and now big is okay, but big is not okay. Being overweight is not okay, y'all. It's not. I'm not trying to fat shame anybody. Everybody just be your normal weight. You don't have to be weighing 350 pounds. That's nothing to be proud of. But if you weigh that, then fine. You know, I'm not here to say what you should. But if you so desire to choose to be a fruitarian or a raw vegan or raw food, you know, this is the way to go. For your health and the planet's health. And just your small decision, a breakfast, lunch, and dinner, you can make the difference for the whole entire planet. And you don't have to be a part of little young children starving in other countries because you being a glutton and having the addiction like drugs, you know, people on crack and meth and what you call it, opioids. That's the way you're addicted to the meat and the fast food, the same thing. So you can't go looking down on drug addicts when you're a drug addict yourself because you're addicted to animal flesh and dairy and eggs and all these things. While other children are dying all over the world because they don't get enough food because of you. Your choices. You're not innocent. Okay? So think about that. And like I said, just be happy and be a fruitarian, okay? Or a vegetarian or a vegan. Higher up the ladder, be better. Okay, more holistic. Have a great day. Tuning out. Nice talking to you today. Thanks for tuning in. Thank you so much. Bye-bye. See you later.